Let's find out together what it actually takes to install a smart relay in your home. Let's see how we can install this Aqara T1 module behind one of the sockets. First thing, we need to have the power off. I put some extra light in here, so we'll just be able to see what's going on. It seems that we have no ground. That's nice. This one is the hot wire, completely wrongly marked, but hey, what can we do? Take the neutral out. I'm gonna clip in a waggle. Take some wire over here. So this is our neutral that will go back in. Let's make this one a little bit shorter. This neutral wire should go over here. That's right in place. This is the live wire. Now we're gonna get the neutral wire. And this end should go back to line one output. We need to make sure that we first pair the module with Home Assistant, because if we don't pair it now, it's gonna be a problem pushing this little button for pairing. Let me set it up real quick and then we'll finish connecting everything. All right, we have paired the module. Now we just need to somehow fit everything inside. Finally got it fit. That's a really big hassle getting all this stuff back into the plug. I have an old style of box. It's a metallic one, but with this occasion I can also pay attention to something else. If you have a metallic box that, like I have, disregarding the fact that it's way smaller and you really have to fiddle with the things around, according to the manual we have to put this antenna out, so we're gonna have to connect it somewhere on this plastic cover. That's what I'm going to do right now. Now we can put the fuse back on, and that's it. Now we are able to see the power consumption behind the unit. Now let me give you a quick look at Home Assistant. First thing, this unit is actually running on a Raspberry Pi 5. Let's go back, Zigbee to MQTT. We already have this living room desk added here. As you can see, it is a router. We can see a small image of the device. And if we go to expose, we can see the power consumption of 61.38 watts, the operating temperature, 240 volts at the plug, and 0.32 amps. If we go to energy dashboard, it is already added here as living room desk energy, and I'm able to see an overall status of what my devices are consuming. Not everything is added yet, but it's a work in progress. I hope you found this video useful. If so, please don't forget to like and subscribe.